Good morning, students. I hope you all are doing well.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yes, good morning. So I hope everyone is doing well. Everyone is fine. Everyone is fine, right? Yes. So yesterday we were discussing something about the particles, right? How small are the particles? The one of the physical nature of matter.
Okay.
Yes. Yesterday we saw the potassium permanganate experiment. I mean, we discussed about it, and today we'll see about it. Okay. Is everyone ready to see how the experiment gets? Everybody, is everybody able to hear me?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, yes.
Okay. Ma'am.
So we'll start our session, okay? And I'm so it's already 9:10, so we'll start a session. So Rims, Anuradha, Gani, grade 9, tell me what we were studying yesterday, where we had stopped yesterday. You can mute yourself and you can tell me. Yes, mute yourself. I have enabled you guys to mute yourself. You can mute yourself and answer me. Where were you last?
Ma'am.
Yes.
Physical nature of matter is teaching.
Yes. So we have studied one of the physical nature of the matter. Okay. That was matter is made up of particles. Yes.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, right.
Yes, ma'am.
Just a minute. Huh? So, did everyone get yesterday the PDF which I sent you?
Yes, ma'am.
Did you go through it?
Yes, ma'am.
Did everyone go through it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, now you have, now you know what we are studying exactly. Do you have any, now, are you getting some idea that what we are actually going through? So this was the first characteristics of the physical nature of the matter. The first, that matter is made up of particles, and we saw an experiment on it. Answer, students. Do you remember
ma'am.
This yesterday?
Yes,
we did this thing.
Yes,
we saw a video also, right, on this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes,
so today, so yesterday
yes, ma'am.
We discussed about how small are the particles of the matter, and today we'll see the experiment of it, okay? Right now we are not physically present in front of each other, so I'll just show you the video how it goes on. What happened? Which home? I did not give you anything yesterday. Okay, guys. Please mute yourself. Please mute yourself. So yesterday at a limit we had stopped. Now we'll start from there, okay?
What I'm going to do is, rather than dissolve... Let's look at the first... That's right. Matter is made up of tiny... Particles of matter are very, very small, made up of time.
Now see, here in the video, he's showing some characteristics, okay? So just go through it.
Tiny particles. In this video, we are going to be discussing these four characteristics of particles of matter, which are, particles of matter are very, very small. They have spaces between them. They are continuously moving and they attract each other. We are going to understand each characteristic with the help of experiments. Let's look at the first characteristic. Particles of matter are very, very small. Let's try an experiment to prove this. For that, I'm going to take a very small quantity of potassium permanganate crystals and we are going to dissolve it in 100 ml of water here. Can you see that deep purple color? Now, if we can show that a very small quantity of potassium permanganate can also color a large volume of water, then that means that these crystals must be containing millions and millions of particles that get spread on dissolving and color the water. So the particles of potassium permanganate must be very, very small. But the trick we are going to do is, rather than dissolve a small quantity of potassium permanganate in a large volume of water, we are going to make use of the purple water here. So we are going to take a small quantity of this purple water and dilute it with more water. And then again take a small quantity of that and further dilute it with more water. It's the same effect as adding a small quantity of this in a large volume of water. Let me show you how. First, I have taken 1/10 of this purple potassium permanganate solution in the small beaker here. So 1/10 of 100 ml is, as you can see, 10 ml. Now I'm going to pour this solution into the empty glass here. And then we are going to dilute it with 90 ml of water so that the total solution becomes 100 ml. So can you see the light purple color now? Now let's take 1/10 of this new solution and again dilute it with water to make the total volume 100 ml. Again, we have taken 10 ml of this light purple solution and we are going to dilute it with water again. So the total volume of the new solution is 100 ml. And can you see the pink color of the solution? And again, we are going to repeat the dilution process with this new solution. So even in this last glass, can you see that light pink color is still visible here? So this process of taking a small part of the colored solution and repeatedly diluting it makes the color go from dark to light. With the help of this experiment, we've shown that if you take the same small quantity of potassium permanganate and put it in a large volume of water, you're going to end up with a light pink color like this last glass here. So what's our conclusion? These tiny crystals of potassium permanganate must be containing millions and millions of potassium permanganate particles, which on dissolving in water, they can spread through the large volume of water and give it a light pink color like this. So the particles of matter must be very, very small. Similarly, a sugar grain is made up of a large number of tiny sugar particles or sugar molecules. Remember, I asked in the beginning of the video, do you know how many sugar molecules are present in one grain of sugar? So one grain of sugar like the one I have on my finger here. So what's your guess here? Is it 1,000 sugar molecules? Or maybe 1,000,000? 1 billion? 1 trillion? Or is it 1 quintillion? That's right. The correct answer is 1 quintillion. That's 1 and 18 zeros. To help you visualize how much is that, I want you to pause the video here and go and get 1 grain.
So everyone understood what he tried to explain you?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll ask a few things now, then we can go forward with it. Okay, Mantesh, yes, you raise your hand. What happened? Tell me. Mahantesh?
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am.
Huh?
Sulfur mel.
Huh?
Huh, ma'am?
What happened?
Experiment sugar.
Sugar,
ma'am.
Huh?
Ma'am. Sugar.
You were saying
one particle of sugar.
Huh?
one tiny particle of sugar is one quintillion particles.
Grain of sugar in the particles.
Quintillion of particles is there.
Yes, yes. There are many particles inside that. See, we know, you know, a matter is made up of, see, just a minute. See, we know that this is a grain of sugar. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So, it has many particles. See here. It has many particles. It is made up of many particles. Understood? Can you see the small, small particles inside the matter? Mantesh, are you clear that a grain of sugar is made up of many particles, like quintillion particles?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, many particles. See. Okay, there is no limit to the particles, okay?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So it is made up of many particles, you say that?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so now you have understood the potassium permanganate experiment?
Yes, ma'am.
So now are you clear that how tiny a particle is? See, how tiny the drop is, but it is a massive color, and then he was distributing the water, the potassium permanganate water, 10 ml in each 90 ml of water. He was diluting. Could you see the pink color which was extending?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So
yes, ma'am.
What is dilution? Tell me first. Anyone? Bhim Ambika, Cayman, T. Bhim Ambika. Bhim Ambika, tell me what is dilution? What do you mean by dilution? Okay, dilution is nothing but reducing the concentration. Yes? Bhim Ambika? See, dilution is nothing but adding water or reducing the concentration of something. Okay. So, see, now we have added a drop of potassium permanganate. Okay. So, as these steps are going forward, we are diluting. We are making the concentration of potassium permanganate less. Okay. We are diluting the solution, which means that we are lessening the concentration of the potassium permanganate. Okay? So see, the moment we take, here it is 100 ml. We have taken 100 ml water. So we add just a drop of potassium permanganate. Okay? And we keep 90 ml of water ready over here. Okay? And then we take 10 ml of potassium permanganate from here and add it. So how much it becomes? 10 plus 90, it becomes 100 ml. Again, we keep 90 ml water ready. From here, we take 10 ml and add it over here. So that becomes 10 ml. I'll just write it down so that you guys understand. See, here basically it is 100 ml and a drop of 100 ml and a drop of potassium permanganate is added, and in the water, it is concentrated at this time. Okay? 10 ml. The water is at 90, okay? The water is at 90. And then 10 is added, okay? Understood? See, it's 10 plus 90 is equal to how much, students? 100?
100.
100.
100. So, this is water, okay? This is water. Here in every, see, from here it's water, 90, water. Here 90 is water. Then we keep adding 10 ml to the water of 90 ml. That's the reason they have shown it here 10. and it's 90, and it becomes 10 plus 90, 100. So as we go forward, can you see in the last step how the color is light, how much the color is light? So this means that the particles are so small that they still continue to come forward, okay? Even if it is dilution. Understood? So estimating how small are the particles of matter with every dilution, though the color becomes light, it is still visible. Don't you think the differences between this and this is very large? Here it is fully concentrated and here it is fully diluted. Here it is, that means here it is so dark, the color is so dark, and here it is so light. Don't you think, students?
Yes, ma'am.
So yes, ma'am.
Did everyone
yes,
understand
ma'am.
This?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am.
See, the
yes,
basic
ma'am.
Part over here
yes, ma'am.
Is to you that how small are the particles
yes, ma'am.
That they come forward. Okay? Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So,
yes, ma'am.
Can anyone tell me what is kinetic energy? Rims, Pratik, Kilare, tell me what is kinetic energy? See, if you don't know, that's okay. You can tell me that you don't know. No problem. I'll teach you. But at least tell me that you know, no? Know or don't know. Yes, Rims, Pratik,
I don't know.
Okay. Okay, you don't know. KMN, Manoj, LT. What is kinetic energy? See, in further topics, we need to know what is... You don't know? Manoj, LT, do you know or no? Manoj, LT, KMN, do you know or don't know? What did he say? Did anyone hear? What did he say? Cayman, Manoj, LT, do you know or don't know? Okay. So, basically, yes, Pratiksha and Aishwarya, tell me.
The energy produced by a motion of an object.
Yes. Correct. Aishwarya?
Energy which a body possesses by virtue of being in a motion.
I'm not able to hear you, Aishwarya. Can you be clear?
Ma'am, energy which a body possesses by virtue of being in a motion.
Yes. Yes, very good. So Pratiksha and Aishwarya, your answers were correct. But what has happened now, like not everyone knows what is kinetic energy. So we'll study about it. Okay. Because see, to go further, to learn a further characteristics of particles, we need to know what is kinetic energy and we need to know what is diffusion. Okay. So anyone knows what is diffusion? Kavya came and Kavya Badnur, tell me. See, if you don't know, say it like you don't know. That's okay. Totally okay. Cayman, Kavya, Badnu, tell me what is a diffusion? Cayman, Abhishek, you tell me what is diffusion? Cayman, Lakshmi, mute yourself, students, and tell me if you don't know whether it's no or yes. Cayman, Ritika, tell me what is diffusion? Yes, Aishra Pujari and Pratiksha, just a minute, wait, okay? We'll ask some people. St. Peter's Tanvi Umrani, tell me what is diffusion?
Separation of unwanted quantities in a mixture.
What? I'm not able to hear you, Tanvi.
Separation of
I'm not able to hear you. Okay. Rims Asia, tell me what is diffusion. St. Peter Chandrasekhar, tell me what is diffusion. Okay, not a problem. I'll tell you. First, we'll learn about kinetic energy and then we'll go to diffusion. Okay? Is everyone fine with it? Three participants raise their hands. Yes, what happened? Tell me. Yes, Pratiksha, tell me.
The moving of particles higher concentration to the lower concentration.
Yes, very good. Anyone else? Okay. Anyone else? I'm not Mama. Able to hear you. Whoever is talking, I'm not able to hear you. Can you be more clear? Can you be more clear? Yes.
You were asking about diffusion.
Yes, yes. I was asking about diffusion.
Of mixing of particles of different spaces together is known as diffusion.
Okay, mixing of particles. Okay. St. Peter's Thanvi, separation of unwanted quantities of a mixture. No, no, no. This is not called diffusion, student. This is not called. I'll just show you what is diffusion. First of all, now, right now, I'll show you what is kinetic energy and then we'll discuss about diffusion. Okay. St. Peter's Snail, dispersion of concentration. Yes, kind of. Correct. Just a minute.
You have a ball which you throw upwards.
See, right now we are seeing what is kinetic energy, okay? Is everyone able to hear?
Yes, miss.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yes,
fine.
Ma'am.
Okay.
Ball travels upwards. We say that it has kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is a form of energy possessed by a body due to its motion. Therefore, anything that moves has kinetic energy. Such as a car traveling on the road, and a plane flying in the sky. Even you possess kinetic energy when you walk or run. In fact, the faster a body moves, the greater its kinetic energy. Therefore, when you run, you have more kinetic energy than when you walk. When a body stops, there is no more kinetic energy. When you come to a stop, or when the car stops moving, kinetic energy becomes zero. If we now raise the ball to a certain height and release it, what happens? It starts falling downwards, right? It starts from a position of rest and then gains speed when you let it go. In other words, it starts with zero kinetic energy and then gains some kinetic energy. Where does this kinetic energy come from? This energy, which is stored in the ball, is called potential energy. Potential energy is a form of energy stored in a body due to its position. Let's have a closer look. Here, the position is the ball's height from the ground. When you release it, the potential energy converts to kinetic energy. In fact, the higher the ball, the larger its potential energy. That is why if we raise the ball to a greater distance from the ground and release it, it will hit the ground harder. Let's look at another example. Look at this slingshot. It has stored energy with which it can throw the bird up to a certain distance. Based on its position in the slingshot, we can say the bird has potential energy. As soon as it's released from the slingshot, it gains kinetic energy. And because of kinetic energy, it is able to apply force on the little houses to break them down. Time for an exercise. Who has the greatest potential energy? Bubbles has the most potential energy because she is at the top. We know that potential energy increases with the increase in the distance of a body from the ground. Let's summarize. Potential energy is the energy of a body due to its position. Kinetic energy, on the other hand, is the energy of a body due to its motion. Potential energy mostly depends on the distance of a body from the ground. Kinetic energy depends on its speed.
So everyone is clear with it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So can anyone tell me what
is... Yes, ma'am.
Can anyone tell me what is kinetic energy now? Or you want me to explain once again?
Okay. The energy which is caused by the movement of an object.
Yes. See, what is kinetic energy? What is energy? What is energy? Tell me, anyone. See, energy is nothing but it's the ability to work. Okay, it's the ability to work. Wait, energy is nothing but ability to do work. Okay. Understood? So energy is nothing but ability to do work. And what is kinetic? Kinetic is nothing but movement or motion.
Kinetic energy.
Or motion.
Motion.
Yes. So what happens? Kinetic energy is nothing but the energy you possess during the movement.
Motion.
Okay. Motion, movement. Okay. Kinetic energy is nothing but the energy one possesses or shows. Okay. Shows when in motion or movement. Did everyone understood? See, the simple examples of this are when you walk.
Yes, ma'am.
See here. Yes. Yes. So simple example is what? Walking. Yes. Your simple example for kinetic energy is nothing but walking. So when you're walking, that means what is happening? Kinetic energy is taking place. And when you're running, then when a car is moving, see, any movement of an object is called kinetic energy. Okay. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
You want to know about energy? See, potential is nothing but it is the energy stored when you're at height. See, this is ground. Okay, this is ground. Yeah, and this is your object far from the ground. So it has some position, right? It is at some height. So your object is at some height. So what is this called? The energy stored in an object at a height or at a distance from ground is called
potential energy.
Okay, understood, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
So, did you see the last example where three people were standing at the top of the mountain and the yellow object was having the higher potential energy because it was too
high
from ground? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So now I hope everyone is clear with kinetic
energy. Yes, ma'am.
Potential energy. Or you want me to explain once again? Is everyone clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So do you have any examples? Anyone? I'll ask. Kaman Lakshmi. Tell me one example, if you know or if you don't know, it's okay. Tell me if you know and even if you don't know. I mean, it's okay if you don't know. Kevin, Lakshmi, tell me an example for kinetic energy? Kavya Badnoor? It's okay.
Flying of a bird.
Yes.
Flying of a bird.
Flying of a bird. Very good. Yes, Mantesh.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am.
Yes.
Flying of airplane.
Yes, very good. Very good. Who said the bird also? Very good. Yes, Cayman Prateek. I'm not able to hear you, Prateek. Rims Aishra Pujari. Rims Aishra Pujari, tell me. Yes, Cayman Pratiksha.
Riding of a bicycle.
Yes, very good. And then Mantesh, yes. Mantesh. Okay. Yes, tell me. You raised your hand. Tell me.
I'm what?
Tell me an example for kinetic energy.
Kinetic energy.
Okay, if you don't know, no problem. KNN Prateek, yes, tell me.
Go!
But listen, everyone, please listen carefully whatever your friends are saying, okay? Because they are giving some great examples. Yes, St. Peter, Sanvita, Madhi.
Ma'am, melting of ice to water.
Melting of ice to water? This is not an example for this. I mean,
it is physical change.
Yeah, this is physical change, but I'm asking you, what is kinetic energy?
Swimming, ma'am.
Moving of bicycle.
Ma'am, boiling of water.
No, we are not studying the change of states of the matter. I'm asking what is kinetic energy?
Ma'am, flowing of water.
Okay.
Flowing of water.
Swimming.
Swimming, okay.
Moving of train.
Moving of train, okay.
Moving of car.
Ma'am, flowing of water.
Yes, yes, yes. Moving of water. Anyone else?
Turning page. Turning page.
Turning page. We're not talking about the chemical changes. We're not talking about the change of state, guys. Students, we're talking about kinetic energy.
Ma'am, skateboarding.
Yes?
Skateboarding.
Running of man.
Running
of man.
Yes, running of man. Very
playing
good.
Playing football.
Yes. So basically, whoever had no idea what is kinetic energy, I think your friends have given many examples, except who are answering for state of state change. Students, it's not, we are not learning state change right now. We are learning at the later stage. Okay. So please listen before and then answer. Yes, Neha Kori.
Throwing of the ball, ma'am.
Yes. It's in motion?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. And again, Mantesh.
Yes, ma'am.
You have raised your hand. Tell me. See, formation of solid to liquid. Someone was saying that for ice melts to water, it's called, the process is called fusion. OK, okay, we have not come to that process. We'll come later. Understood, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, do not confuse
yes, ma'am. With
this. Right now, we're studying about kinetic energy. Okay? So, I'll see you tomorrow. I just have 2 minutes left. Okay? So, I hope everyone has understood today's topic. Everyone is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay.
So, you're on mute.
Yes? Okay, so in next class, we'll study about diffusion and 3 more characteristics of matter. Okay, the particles of matter have space between them. Particles of matter are continuously moving, and particles of matter attract each other. So we'll study these 4 topics in next class. Okay, so I hope till then you're safe and do not go out. Okay, and take care of yourself. Okay,
yes,
I'll see you in the next class.
Okay,
chalo. Bye. Bye.